Tonight on the Studio Review, we're headed to what many have called the pizza capital of the world, New Haven, Connecticut, and we're gonna find out who's got the best pizza in town. We're also gonna light some stuff on fire and introduce a brand new segment. Three segments, 5 minutes, here we go.
This is the Studio Review.
Welcome to season two of the Studio Review. I'm so glad you're here. We're gonna kick tonight's episode off by saying goodbye to some more things that have come to their final chapter. This is Funeral for a Friend. We are gathered here today to say goodbye to summer. As of this week, Pumpkin Spice Everything is back, and over 1,300 vacant retail stores in the US and Canada are reopening their doors as Spirit Halloweens. I was still mourning the loss of summer 2020, and this news really caught me off guard. Next, we part ways with the Mountain Dew promotion, 100 Days of Baja. You may have just been a marketing ploy, but you blessed us with the best summer of Mountain Dew ever. Baja Blast Classic, Baja Flash, and Baja Punch. Gone too soon, but not soon to be forgotten. And finally, we laid to rest the first 5 theatrical release dates for the latest James Bond film, No Time to Die. You're currently scheduled to be released in late September, but we won't hold our breath. May they rest in peace. This next segment is brand new, and it's an opportunity to salute some people that are doing some really amazing stuff out there. This is Cheers. This week I'm raising a cheer wine, which if you haven't had it, is easily one of the greatest soft drinks ever created. To my sister Kate, who just finished through hiking the entire Appalachian Trail. That's 2,193 miles. She literally went from Georgia to Maine on foot. She started in 2020, but the Trail Conservancy asked hikers to stop due to COVID, so she literally rearranged her entire life so she could make another attempt at it this year, but started all the way back from the beginning. She fought through a ton of challenges, including a full-on stress fracture in her foot, but never gave up. So Kate, cheers to you for achieving a lifelong dream, and here's to the next adventure. Before our final segment, this is just a quick reminder that if you enjoy the Studio Review, a really easy way to support it is by clicking that subscribe button right down there. And finally, it's time to determine the best pizza in the entire world. It's another installment of Revue, Revue. Tonight, we're pitting Modern Beats against Frank Pepe's Pizzeria Napoletana, both from New Haven. Technically, New Haven-style pizza is spelled a pizza, but it's pronounced a beats. And among other things, it means that it's slightly misshapen and has a thin, crispy crust, but it stacks up really well to pizza from anywhere else in the world. From Modern, I ordered the Italian Bomb Pizza, and from Pepe's, I ordered the Amante della Carne, which is just Italian for lover of meat. I guess technically, the most objective way to do this would be to order one cheese pie from each place, but I just ordered the ones that I like the best because, to be honest, this whole thing is pretty subjective anyway. Each pizza is gonna get a 1 to 10 rating in 8 different categories, and those categories are presentation slash appearance, first bite, also known as mouth feel, grease, and 10 in grease means that it has an appropriate level of grease, cheese, sauce, toppings, crust, and last but not least, wow factor. So a 10 in that category means very memorable, and a 0 in that category means totally forgettable. First up, we've got the Italian Bomb from Modern. The Italian Bomb has bacon, sausage, pepperoni, mushroom, onion, pepper, and garlic. All right, here we go. Wow, okay. First of all, for presentation, I'm gonna go 9.5 out of 10. You just take a look at this thing and you know that it's gonna be good. For the first bite or the mouthfeel, I'm gonna go 10 out of 10 because I'm already having a great time. For the grease, I'm gonna go 8. Pretty appropriate level of grease. Cheese is pretty good. I'm gonna go 8 as well. Now for the sauce, I'll give it a 9. And then toppings, I'm gonna give this a 9.5. I think the garlic adds a really nice touch. The bacon is super high quality, very tasty. Peppers and onions, all really good quality. And finally, the crust. The crust is pretty typical of New Haven style pizza, but nothing to write home about. And for the last category, wow factor, I'm gonna give it a 10 out of 10 because this is easily one of the most memorable pizzas I've ever had. Okay, next up, the meat lovers from Pepe's. The Pepe's pizza has crushed Italian tomatoes, mozzarella, meatball, pepperoni, sausage, bacon, and grated Romano. Almost forgot to cleanse my palate. Okay, right off the bat for appearance, I'm gonna go 8 out of 10. I feel like this is a really good looking pizza. Not quite as good looking as the one from Modern, but still pretty nice. The mouthfeel, I'm gonna give it an 8.5. And then the grease, I'm gonna give this one a 6. There's just a little bit too much grease for my taste on this pizza. Cheese will go 9 out of 10. Sauce is an 8 out of 10, not as noticeable on this one. And then the toppings are a 9 out of 10. So different toppings, obviously, but I really like that the pepperonis have little char marks around the outside. Adds a nice little touch of flavor. The crust is just a little bit chewy, so I'll give it a 7.5, but for wow factor, 9 out of 10. Still a really good pizza. Okay, so that means that the Italian Bomb pizza from Modern finished with an average score of 9.0, and the Amante della Carne from Pepe's finished with an average score of 8.125, which I'd support that final conclusion. I think if I had to pick just one, I'd probably go to Modern over Pepe's, but both really phenomenal pizzas. So there you have it, the best pizza in the entire world. Take that, Old Forge, Pennsylvania. Hey, before you go, I just want to let you know that this Friday, September 10th, is World Suicide Prevention Day. It's a great day to remind yourself or a friend that the world is a better place with you in it. But that wraps it up for episode 1. Thank you so much for joining me. Episode 2 will come out next Saturday, so make sure you're subscribed by clicking right here so you don't miss out on new episodes. But hey, until then, just remember that even when it doesn't feel like it, it's going to be okay. I'll see you soon.